My boys.
Fix our hair, guys. Fix our fucking hair. Come on.
We're all my boys here. Where are all my boys here? Oh, are you in attendance? Is my boy here?
I'm there's one of your boys.
Okay, here. We got both of my boys here. We got both of the boys. Oh man, it's great to be here with you guys.
It's great to know you guys.
I love you, boys.
I'm killing it. We'll start off with
I love you, boys.
James, you're killing it. You are.
I love you, boys. I just wish my frame was bigger and filled up the whole thing.
Didn't you have it working before?
It worked last time somewhat, but it was still kind of cropping the sides. But now, I don't know. It seems like it's getting smaller each week.
Dude, on the plus side.
It eventually just gets so small.
Yo, on the plus side, though, you're able to have it on the entire time.
Yeah, that's crazy.
And we are able to now hear each other without... like if someone talks, it doesn't push someone else underneath, which is amazing.
Mm-hmm.
So now we're going to be able to fully talk over each other.
Right.
Entirely. And we won't like stop to see like, what was I saying?
Cutting you off there.
This is a whole new era, dude. We have three sponsors today. We have, what else is going on? Mandalorian's out. Fucking
Steve got a perm. I got a perm.
Why does it look like you got a perm?
I got a perm.
You did not get a perm,
dude. Yeah, I did.
No, he just did this with his hair.
You just did this with your hair.
I just did the normal.
But see, Steve, it looks like you're not liking the perm because it seems like you're starting
it
to
seems
like
you've been,
yeah,
really at it.
Dude, I have no idea how to style it. I truly have no idea.
When you wash it next, that's when it's going to come back to the curls. Remember she said it's going to get weird and then you're going to wet it and then the curls are going to come back.
Well, I already did wet it.
Fully?
Yeah, last night I used... conditioner. I didn't use shampoo, so maybe that's why. But you'd think that
that wouldn't be why conditioner would help.
Yeah. I don't know. It looks good.
It still looks good, but it doesn't look what I think.
What I thought it was supposed to look like. Yeah.
Yeah.
You looked amazing the other day when I saw you.
Oh, baby.
Yeah. It's today. I don't know exactly how to do it. I think I might have to have her come back. I think I washed it too early.
Maybe. Did you wait 2 days?
Kib, tell me, does he not look, or at least the other day, when the perm was still fresh, he looked just like Jack Harlow.
Are you trying to remember who that is?
No, I don't. I mean, I think the hair did.
Yeah.
Dude, but Jack Steve. Harlow is like the third twin. It's Nick, Steve, and Jack Harlow.
Oh, let's fact check.
Everybody
that.
Knows Jack Harlow is part of the game.
Dude, there's a picture of Jack Harlow that looks exactly like Nick. I'll show you. Jack
I'm
Harlow.
Fact check out. Right back.
I'll send you the pic.
Face-wise, Nick and Jack Harlow for sure.
Dude, here, I'm linking it in the general chat. Oh, Kib's gone. I linked it in the general chat. Okay, well, what do you want to talk about while Kib's gone?
Oh, man, we could talk about just about...
Dude, we can talk about Mandalorian season 2 now.
Pretty much anything.
Episode 3?
Looks just like him.
Episode 3, mm-hmm. I enjoyed it.
I did too, but I think it was way too short, dude. It was only 30 minutes.
Sorry, guys, got lost.
Minus credits. Just hang on a second, Kib. Minus credits, 30 minutes.
So short. So short.
It's ridiculous. And I looked at the other episodes because I was like, why was this one so short? They're all like 38 to like 40 minutes. And I was like, make them an hour.
Yo, but here's the thing. How are they able to get his ship to look so good when it has water coming all out of it? As opposed to the speeder bikes in the first couple episodes that just looked like shit. Doesn't make any sense.
It honestly could have been like different teams.
Potentially, yeah. Do you see the picture, Kib?
I just looked him up and he looks nothing like you.
Dumbass.
His face looks just like Nick, dude.
Look, okay, go to the general. Yo, Kip, go to the general chat right now. You see it?
All right.
Him
go
with
to general.
Glasses.
Okay, hang on.
And then
him with glasses.
Look at the picture I linked. Okay, it's exactly Nick. You're not even going to believe it.
Whoa.
Right? Right?
Moo, dude. That angle, dude. Moo, dude.
That's insane.
It's like,
I know.
It's like if Nick, you know, mixed with...
Yeah, I know. Dude, I know exactly what you...
And
if Nick
also went to a carnival
moo.
And fucking ate all the fucking corn dogs at a concession stand, dude.
We have a long-time sponsor. You guys know about him. But if you're not using it, why? Why wouldn't you use it? You guys know about us. Yeah. I have it activated. I've had it activated the entire time I've used the internet since I was born.
Easily.
It's Honey. Honey is our first sponsor of the day.
Delicious.
These days, it feels like online shopping is the only shopping we really do. Ain't that the truth? Besides, like, the one time I've gone to a thrift store, which I had to wait outside of for a really long time because of the 6-foot distance. Anyway, that's a story for night for no time.
Skip the story, Steve. Get back to the sponsor.
We're
going to
skip the story. Go straight to the sponsor.
Please skip the story.
Forget the thrift store. I shop online mostly, and that's where today's sponsor, Honey, comes in.
Boom!
It's a free browser extension that scours the internet for promo codes and automatically tests them when you're checking out. Honey is basically your online shopping best friend. I have a lot of best friends, but no online best friends that I shop with. Here's how it works. You get Honey on your computer for free in two easy clicks. Then when you're checking out on one of its over 30,000 supported sites, Honey pops up and all you have to do is click apply coupons. Wait a few seconds as Honey searches for coupons for that site. If Honey finds working codes, which most of the time it does, it'll apply the best one to your cart. What have I purchased recently? Shampoo for my perm.
Shampoo for his perm.
Yeah, I...
Shamperm.
Originally, I was going to go with the Maui shampoo and conditioner, which I typed into Amazon, and I thought that's what I was going to go with. And I thought I clicked on it, but I clicked on the wrong one. But I still, even though I clicked on the wrong one, I still got a discount from Honey. So how about that?
That's fantastic, man.
That's actually insane.
Don't say wow like you're...
It would have been more effective if you didn't add in the part where you ordered the wrong one.
But hey, think about that, man. I ordered the wrong one, still a discount.
Still a discount.
Wow.
Still a discount. Yeah. Honey has found its over 17 million members, over $2 billion in savings. And they support all kinds of retailers from tech and gaming sites to fashion brands to even food delivery. Ruh-roh, Raggy. That's pretty insane.
Moo.
Yeah, moo, kid. That's exactly right. That's exactly right, bud. Well, it's simple. If you have a computer, Honey should be on it. How about that? It's free, and whatever browser you're using, it's going to be, you're able to get it on it. I mean, if you're using Opera, like a fucking pervert, you can get it, you can use it.
Fucking Bing.
Bing. Don't use Bing, but use Honey.
Bing.
Bing, though. Yeah.
You can get Honey for free today at joinhoney.com/beyond.
Beyond.
That's joinhoney.com/beyond.
Beyond.
Once again, that's joinhoney.com/beyond. So they know we sent you. Thanks, Honey, for supporting today's episode.
We did.
Honey, we fucking love you.
Truly.
We love you, Honey.
You hear me?
One.
Yeah, besides the
honestly,
perm,
if you're not using Honey, what are you doing?
Literally.
Yeah.
Truly,
literally,
though.
What are you doing right now?
What are you doing right now? Yeah. And what are you wearing?
Yeah. What are you doing? What are you wearing?
Where are you wearing?
You know what I mean?
Yeah, Steve, besides the fucking perm thing, there's really nothing new going in my life.
Nothing new?
There's really nothing new going on in my life.
Moo! Steve's got some explaining to do.
Moo! Dude, are you seriously vaping again?
Yeah, I, wow. It's not like a, this is a very recent thing. Very recent, like, past.
What made you get back into it?
All my friends were doing it. Everyone in the house is doing it. And it's really impossible to avoid.
That's a hard
so
thing.
I figure,
That's
you know what?
Thing.
And it wasn't exactly, once it starts affecting my exercise routine, that's when I know it's time to quit. But, so far I've been just as energetic as ever, just as, besides today, I'm feeling a little tired.
Just damn, as hot dude. As ever though.
Kib, are you vaping again too?
I wouldn't do that to you. You know what I mean?
I know you wouldn't. I'm not vaping.
James is vaping!
He's not vaping. James, that's not even
no,
a vape. James's thing isn't a vape.
That's CBD oil.
This is what a vape looks like. James's thing isn't a vape.
Okay, it's that one's green, and then that one, that smoke that came out of his mouth did that. That
now, before everyone
too.
Watching
well,
that
was
is
because
so
I was
disappointed.
Eating nitrous, I was eating nitrous, like liquid
You're
nitrous.
You're eating
nitrous.
Your mattress.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. Before everyone in the comments says they're all disappointed in us, I just want to say
we're adults.
I'm disappointed in myself.
No, you're not. I am.
In me?
Yes.
I just understand it, man. I get the addiction. Process,
I just understand. You know? Just a total understand. Good friend.
Wrong understand. Place,
you
wrong
know
time,
what, man?
Man.
Bottom line, time. I understand.
Yeah. Bottom line. It's tough. It's really tough.
Dude, your After body, your choice.
You yeah. Know? I
your
wish
body,
that it wasn't
my
choice,
choice,
to be honest.
Dude.
I wish this was forced
vaped.
Upon me.
Dude, I haven't vaped since March.
Yeah,
do
I haven't
you,
vaped.
Do you want to be forced to stop, Steve? Because I can help. Easy, bro. You want me to tap into that?
The only
that
way,
guy?
No. The only way I'm ever gonna be able to. I mean, I'll probably be able to stop on my own again.
I can be so annoying about it and be like, bro, just stop, and then you'll be annoyed with me and not want
to
hang out.
And I'll hear you say, "I'll." That's
you
wait. That's your attempt,
you
dude. That's your attempt,
no, that,
right there.
This was bro. My attempt just now. That's like that's it,
bro. Just stop.
Come on, man.
Come on. Just, yeah. Okay. I've decided I'll stop.
There it is.
Thank you, bro.
That's how we fucking do it. I also just wanted to point out. James, look like you were putting what was it? Seagull's pheromone on your wrist.
Seagull's. Yep, it was seagull pheromone.
Dude, he's trying to get seagulls to mate with him.
I've got this wonderful, wonderful little blend of essential oils. It's called a focus blend.
Okay.
And it's got, let's see, let's read the
placebo,
ingredients. Placebo, huh? It's got Cocos nucifera, okay. Also known as fractionalized coconut oil.
Got a little bit of asbestos in
it's
there.
Got vetiveria.
It's the best asbestos.
It's got avacadabra.
It's got vetiveria zizanionoids, which is vetiver root oil. It's got
a veteran's armor.
Veteran's armor. Oil,
citrus clementina peel oil or clementine oil. And it's got Rosmarinus officinalis leaf stem oil, also known as rosemary. Vinny, shut
That's
up.
What rosemary
Come
is
on,
called?
Vinny, shut up.
Come on, Vinny, shut the fuck up.
Who just rang my doorbell
at this hour?
I'm here, dude.
I think that's Lauren.
Let me back in. Let me Come back on, Dean.
I'm filming the podcast. This isn't funny. This isn't funny anymore.
She's like, this isn't funny anymore.
I'm so bummed. You know my little necklace that I always wear?
Yeah.
This one?
Did you grow out of it?
Broke it.
I just bought a necklace, James.
The string broke, but luckily, I mean, just to get the little black like cord is just like $4.
So you got to pin it to your skin.
Do you have it right there? Can we see it?
This one that I always wear. My little stone, my little black.
Oh, I thought that was a lob.
What was the thing that went around your neck? Was it a rope or was it a chain or?
It was just like a little black cord.
Cool.
One of the adjustable ones where it's like double knotted and you can just like. Zzz.
No
but,
joke.
But it just broke.
The past like 3 days, I for some reason just was like, I wonder if I could wear like a little gold chain, like 1-2 millimeter thin gold chain.
Dude, I have my gold chain. I love that little gold chain. Oh. Super thin and classy. Yeah. Not a thick ass fucking chain.
No, dude. Your chain shouldn't be like, look at my chain. It should be like, if you happen to notice it, you go,
exactly.
Wow, that's cool. That's a great little accessory.
I like a little gold chain that's like this thin.
That's why I wear Flavor Flav's clock. Just this giant fucking thing. So I never figured.
You keep it
is,
under your shirt, so it's like an Iron Man arc reactor on your chest.
That's my pacemaker.
Nice reference, dude. That's fucking DC.
Thanks, dude. Nice. That's so not DC, and I'm pissed you said
that's
that.
Thor Nerd. Ragnarok.
Is this DC? That's is Thor this Ragnarok. DC?
Dude, are you pulling on your nipples right now?
Are these DC?
Are these DC?
No, they're not.
They're not DC. No, they're not.
Yeah, I'm not excited to be vaping again.
It's okay.
I just really like the feeling of it. It's what
you know
it
what?
Is.
I'll tell you how I got back into vaping. I have an actual story.
Yeah, tell me
it wasn't
how I can
just
get
like,
back into it, please.
I'll tell you exactly how you can get back in. Guys, if you're listening, everyone out there, if you're listening and you really want to get back into vaping,
please don't get back into vaping.
Let me tell you how.
Just to start that up, just to preface that.
You're ruining my joke, Steve.
But it's a good, this is an important forewarning. The joke's still going to land, trust me.
The joke's not going to land.
It's not going to, trust me.
Wait, I'm getting mixed signals from you guys. Is it going to land?
It's
going to
land,
not?
But Steve, you're on a noble trail.
I'm on thin
right
ice,
now.
Yeah.
No, you're on a noble trail, dude. Continue.
A noble trail.
No, you know trail. What? I'm going to let the trail fizzle out because I want Jokes James to land.
Jokes James, get it.
Okay, guys, everybody, welcome back to James.
I do want
to
hear the story of how you got back into it, though. I really do.
Okay, so this is what happened. September 25th.
11th.
September 11th, 2001.
September 11th. I was feeling sad.
No, the music videos I've been shooting, the first one we did went up to the Bay to shoot, and one of my best friends, Lucas, who also gaffed the project, the day before we were shooting, we were scouting locations, and we're in his car going to one of the locations, and he like pulls out a puff from like his side of his door, and he's just like, dude, here. And I was like, oh fuck yeah.
Dude, with no hesitation.
No hesitation.
Took it.
Oh fuck yeah.
I was just
back,
like, oh
baby.
Fuck yeah. And then I hit it, and then he was like, hey, that's yours for the weekend, director. And I was like, this is bad. And then
this
the entire
nepotism.
Weekend, then the entire weekend I was fucking smoking it. And I was like, this can't be good. Went home and I was like, I got another one for the drive because that one was done. I literally smoked an entire one in fucking 2 days. And then for the drive back, I wanted to get one. But then I was like, when I get there, I'm going to throw it away. I'm not going to be vaping because I know also Lauren isn't going to be cool with that. And I also don't want to do that, right? I don't want to get back into it. Yeah.
So now.
Didn't happen. Got into it.
If you don't talk about it, whatever. Just say no. Does Lauren care now?
No, she's vaping with me.
You did this, man.
I didn't do anything. She's a human too. She has will.
Just
but
like
I
you
told her,
you
don't want to catch one of these, Lauren. You're gonna smoke it, and then you're gonna let me have pizza for dinner,
and then you're gonna let me have pizza. Then you're gonna let me have pizza.
Oh man,
she didn't want me to have pizza, but she did get addicted. It was great.
I have a similar story actually to Lauren's about getting back into vaping. Is that it was at Bruce's Halloween party, I think, and at first it was cigarettes, which I really don't like cigarettes, but it's just, I don't know, it's fun when you're drunk. And then I had a hit of James's vape, and immediately, you remember that scene from Ratatouille where the villain tries
to seen Ratatouille.
He tries the actual Ratatouille, and then he gets brought back to his childhood. One hit of the vape, and I fucking got brought back to my childhood. And it was so sick.
Back to when he fucking passed out on the ground and his pants fell down in the winter.
You keep bringing up that story,
and he was being,
and adding new facts to it every time.
Paralyzed from the waist down, and he was dragging himself through snow, and his fucking dick was.
He pissed his pants, dude. And he pissed, and he just fucking his legs just fucking went through it all,
and his legs just fucking fell off.
Dude, fucking dick got frostbite. Just fell off.
Yeah.
Anywho, go ahead, Steve.
But no, I mean that's and then I kind of like held off a little bit, but then I had opportunities between then and now to vape, which, and then I kept taking those and then I started to realize, oh, this is going to be a problem. Then I would go on hikes and I would go on my normal exercise and I was able to do them just as I was before, which I almost wish I wasn't able to do that. Yeah. I gave myself a reason. And then
you're like, what's the matter then? What's the matter?
And then I bought one that was from someone that was in the house. I bought it from them because I was like, I don't want to go to a store and then get one. No, I did buy one from a store, but I hit it for like an hour and then I just gave it away.
Mm-hmm.
And then I today just bought one from a roommate. So
we're here
now.
You know,
so you're buying used ones.
Yeah, I was gonna say, you know, you should just get your own. They're like,
yeah, that's expensive. The thing is, I should just get my own, but I feel like if I get my own, then I admit defeat, you know?
You've defeated.
I've been defeated over, already. Yeah. I realize that. I've been defeated.
The credits are rolling, dude, and you're still buying.
No, but there's
ones,
an after the credits scene.
There's not.
It's there
you
is.
Fucking tweaking
it's me
out
fucking
on the floor.
Falling down in the snow and getting dick frostbite and trying to. All my muscles atrophy.
That's Steve's happy place, man.
Yeah, so I'm back on the sauce, baby.
Hey.
Hell yeah, dude.
You gotta do what you gotta do, bro.
Just for a little bit.
Hey, it's inevitable. It's inevitable. And not even in like a sad way. It's inevitable that you're at least going to do it again a little bit after you quit on and off.
Mm.
But like the bottom line is you know that you can quit. Like I know that I can quit. And I like quitting things cold turkey because that's the only way I can. I can't wean myself off of things. I have to just be like, I'm stopping.
Pretty much.
And I'll be pissed for a couple of days, but then I'll just be like, whatever.
I'll tell you, it's probably a lot easier to quit one of those big vapes than it is to quit one of these because this is a consistent amount every time. And those big vapes,
it's
you can like wean it out with 0 milligrams, and that's the way I did it before. I don't know
but
how.
But you're a wiener,
You are a wiener.
You're a wiener.
Sorry,
man.
I think there was something in my room that just made a noise.
Yeah, it was a bunch of bugs.
No, there wasn't.
Sorry, I didn't
no,
catch
there wasn't.
Did you say something? We'll just move
you're
on.
You're a wiener.
I'm not a wiener.
You're a wiener, dude.
Not a wiener,
you
dude.
You wean off things.
I can quit any fucking.
You're hitting it right now. You can't. You didn't even finish your sentence before you hit the next drag.
Time I want.
Okay.
God.
I don't think that's true.
That
I don't
is.
Believe that,
that
for
is
a
just.
Second. And you quit so, for a few months too.
A year.
Yeah.
Look
like
at you, dude. Your 1 year
back
chip,
on this house.
Give it back.
Give it back.
This is mine, dude.
What is? Is that a coin? Was that a half an Oreo?
How's
what is that?
Old pop socket. That fell
no,
off.
It's a
it
lens
was an old
cap.
Popsicle.
No, it was an old popsicle.
That's what I'll...
what did you just say?
Hold on.
No,
dude.
Oh, man.
It's definitely disappointing. I'm going to heat up some coffee real quick.
Okay. Sure.
Sure, man.
You can heat up
no,
some
No, I'm
coffee.
Being serious.
How are you going to heat it up?
In my little Keurig. What? What
so
do
you
mean? How am I going to
make some coffee?
I'm going to make it. I should have just said I'm going to make some coffee.
I'm going to heat up some coffee.
I don't know why I said
heat.
I don't know why I said
creating it as well. James, how you
man,
been,
it makes
brother?
Me want some tea.
Hey, James, what's going on with those fucking projects right now? Are you working on one? Did you finish all of them? What's the
no,
move?
No. I mean, well, yes. I know I didn't finish them. I just brought footage over to Steve.
Dope.
To
dope.
Start editing the first yep. one.
Did you make this one look as incredible as the last?
The one I just shot?
Yeah.
Oh yeah!
Oh yeah!
Oh yeah!
I guess
what camera did you use
they
for the second
incredible.
One?
Red Dragon.
Oh, was that dope? Was
10K.
It, did you like that? Did you like the footage from that more than the footage from the Ari?
I like no. The footage from the Ari was spectacular,
it
but
was spectacular.
We also had the lenses we were using, the Blackwing lenses have a really nice, like, kind of soft vintagey look to them, even though they're like brand new. Mm-hmm. And then we also had like pro haze filters and like a rainbow filter. And then we also used, for the outdoor shots that you're going to see, Steve, we had a tobacco filter on, which adds like such a cool warmth to it.
Tobacco filter.
Yeah.
I've never
so, like, there
tobacco.
Were all these amazing filters like combined with the lenses, plus just the way that Ari captures stuff. Yeah, you love tobacco, dude. So I don't know. It depends. Like, I like the picture that's captured on the Ari better, I think. Like, there's more, there's less of a, my friend Nick put it really well. Like, the red is amazing, but it gives a very, like, crisp digital image. You know, it's, like, very, very digital. Mm-hmm. But the Ari has a lot more range where you can, like, manipulate it more, like, with shooting to make it not feel so digital.
Is it a more expensive camera, too?
The Ari?
The Ari Mini is so expensive. It's like 40K.
Ari Mini LF?
I thought the Red Dragon was still like 30K or something.
No. Like the Red 20. Dragon now is I think the one that we shot on was probably 15, 18.
They seem like they're old news now. Like
the Reds?
Yeah.
Well, no, I mean, dude, they just released the Komodo, which is a little tiny. They're compact, dude. The body's this big.
Okay.
Little cube. It's sick.
Yeah.
I'd be it down to own it. Cool. Dude, it's 6K for the body.
Oh,
like,
wow,
that's incredible.
I'd be down to own it, like anything.
There's also a really cool new Blackmagic camera that like looks more like a DSLR, like a more traditional DSLR.
You're talking about the Blackmagic Cinema Pocket Cinema camera?
Mm,
there's also the 6K.
I think I'm talking about the 6K. It looks more like a Canon.
But it is, like it's the Pocket. Or something. It's the Cinema Pocket camera.
I know about the Pocket one, but this one's newer than the Pocket Cam, I think.
If I were to get another camera at this point, I would definitely get the Cinema Pocket camera.
Oh yeah, I think that's the most bang for your buck, unless you're like an actual like cinematographer.
Yeah.
And then I think I'd be down to have the Red Komodo, because that's just like so tight. Like you get like a full on like cinema quality Red camera, but it's so small.
If you could own any camera in the world, what would it be? Well, I guess not any, besides like high class movie production
IMAX
cameras, like the Arri Alexa XT or whatever.
The highest level of Arri that you would allow me to have.
Arri Mini, then. I think I would also go for the Arri Mini, because that's like, that's it. To be honest.
Yeah, but that's just, anything. I mean, that's it. I don't, it's not worth owning that unless you are a career like cinematographer.
Right. Yeah. It's not practical on an everyday basis for anything that we do.
Like, imagine that being set up right now as our webcam.
Dude, it's like the body's twice the size of like the C200, I think.
Really?
Yeah, it's about this big.
Jesus.
Oh, so still bigger than the C200 though.
Dude, that's the Arri Mini.
Yeah, right? Mini, dude, the Arri, the regular ones, they're fucking huge. It's unbelievable. And then, dude, James is for the music videos. Like, James has used the Arri Mini mixed with a stock Canon lens.
Just a little, you know, little 18 to 35 Tamron lens.
Yeah. I heard that James actually.
That comes with a T3i kit.
I heard that James actually he'll change the setting in the camera to shoot with no lens a lot of the time. Mm-hmm.
Just open sensor.
Yeah, open sensor. He makes it work, but.
And then we just CGI the whole thing.
Yeah.
Someone no, sick though. And then
James
on the
just destroy his own footage after he shoots, just so he can, you know, live in the moment.
Just so he can feel,
so he can feel
control
something again.
But then we shot on a Leica kit with the red that were beautiful.
Cool.
Oof. Yeah, you talked about the Leica.
You're excited to
start
Leica
fucking G6
videos.
Baby.
He's gonna be fucking
very
sick.
Very excited.
Very excited. So what's new with you boys? Anything new happening in your life?
You know, got that fucking necklace.
Oh, you fixed your car.
That's about it.
Yeah.
Oh
my
God,
dude. Huge. So went to the specialist. He didn't do any like physical tests other than like listening to my breathing and stuff like that. Guy's a genius. He's like, all right, you qualify for all three of these possible things. Postnasal drip, acid reflux that comes back up and it goes into your larynx. And then that's the cough. Or just straight up asthma and allergies. And that could be why you have that infection in your lungs. And he's like, we're going to treat you for postnasal drip and the asthma and allergies first. And if in 6 weeks your cough's not any better, even if it's a little bit better, he's like, then we're nailing it on the head. But he's like, if it's not better, you'll come back and then we'll go fucking do the fucking.
Yeah, you're barely even coughing anymore. We can play tennis.
I haven't even
soon.
Heard you cough.
I haven't.
This whole time.
I haven't.
I'm so excited.
Better.
Incredible, man.
He gave me a way high dose of a steroid inhaler. And this machine, actually, where the fuck is it? That's nowhere near. But this machine, it's just this little tube that connects to the end of it so that when you spray it, normally the shit will go just on your tongue and you won't breathe in a lot of it. And this, it turns more into like air before it gets in and it goes down in your lungs. And then a fucking nasal steroid nasal spray. Here we are. And then he just told me to just keep taking Zyrtec. So those are the three things I'm on. And the second day, because I got it at night, tried it that night. Next day, I was already feeling like 20% better. I was like,
what percentage are you at right now?
Probably like 85, 90%.
Fuck yes, dude. We can play tennis again.
That's humble. That's me being humble. I could be even better.
When do you want to play tennis?
I could be even better.
I think physical activity, I want to give myself five more days. Yep. Yeah, maybe a week.
Cool. In. That's probably
because I went on a couple walks, a couple small walks, and it was all right. I was a little more tired than I should have been in my lungs, but I wasn't coughing. You know, We'll get there. I'm very happy because I was sick for like 3 fucking months, boys. Didn't like it.
It was gross.
It was gross, man.
Yeah. Not I didn't want to be near you.
Top of the world, man. Look at me now.
You are on top of the world. I went for a hike with old Brett the other day.
Oh yeah, how was it?
Yeah, we went on a hike. It was great. It's great to see him.
Sweet. Oh, speaking of Brett, I know what we can talk about. A disappointing meal we had.
Ooh, I knew it. I fucking knew it.
Ugh. I mean, it wasn't just Brett. It was Tay as well. They both were like, you got to go to home state. It's all the rage. I think it started in Texas or something. Yeah, you got to touch
all the rage.
It's a taco place I think it originated in Texas, maybe. Who knows? But it's here now, and it's just like in Hollywood. And I was so excited because during the pandemic, when does anything ever happen? So I was excited just to get out of the house. But to drive 30 minutes to Hollywood for these tacos.
30 minutes back.
Bruv, they were just okay. Mm-hmm. They were just okay. They're like,
I give them like a 6.5.
I can't believe it. Like,
did you get the sauce for it at least? Did you get the sauce for it? So I was like, oh, fuck, we probably missed some type of sauce. She just meant like verde sauce.
You can only trust certain people.
Yeah, the salsa that comes
food.
With it.
With every taco that
with
ever
every
exists.
Single taco, yeah. And if it doesn't, it's like, better be a specialty taco.
Exactly. Got the brisket tacos, and it was just like bland, like they didn't season the meat.
Yeah.
Like it was nothing. But the tortillas, I will say the tortillas were great. I would give the tortillas themselves a 10.
I like the grease too.
Yeah, like because they were flour tortillas. You know how like tacos that size are usually corn tortillas? They were flour tortillas that were that big.
Right.
And they were like a little bit thicker and they had a nice little chew to them. Like a chewy kind of texture. Oh, and they
truly
were
delicious tortillas. Yeah.
But the second we were eating them, we were like, man, we should have just gone to Diablo. And then I did that the day after. So last night I had Diablo.
Oh, baby. Dude, I've been talking about Diablo lately, man. I need it. Steve, what was that taco place we went to? With Andrew, that Andrew brought us to.
Tacos El Venado.
Bangarang. You should have
so good.
Went there.
Best pastor tacos I've ever
Best
had in my life.
Best pastor tacos I've ever had in my life.
Truly. There's never been a better pastor taco, and I've had so many pastor tacos. And then
at least
I tried to go there with Bob while we were here, and we got there an hour early.
Bob had a fit, so you had to
And
leave.
We walked up to the, while they were setting up, and Bob had a what?
A fit, dude. He started knocking over the meat.
And I was like, calm down.
Knocking over the meat.
No,
they have this big fucking pastor meat wheel.
God. It's amazing. I love tacos.
And Bob just started punching it.
Dude,
we gotta go
back
on a taco
memories.
Trip this year, man. We gotta go, well, once I guess everything opens back
up. Yeah, let's fucking do a taco trip,
Let's
bro.
Fuck it up.
That's a video that I'll always want to do, man.
Bro,
eating
for once
tacos
in our lives, can
boys?
We just fuck it up? Bro,
tacos
please.
With my boys?
For once in our life, boys, God can we please it. Just fuck it up?
Yup.
Yes.
Yeah.
I'm down to begin. Yup. And fuck.
Yup. That sounds like the best.
Because everyone does this fucking thing. Like,
you gotta explain to the audio listeners, dude. Come on.
Because everybody does this thing. Dude, no one. I mean,
explain it.
Just
care about it and explain.
It's hard
it,
to
and
it's hard to explain. It's hard to explain
well,
what I'm
do
going
it.
For.
Just do
okay,
it.
Okay. So I won't just do it. How do I even explain this? Everyone, when they laugh, they jut their head up. Not everyone when they laugh, but you know, when you have a good chuckle, a good snortle, you fucking put your head up like this.
A squirtle.
Yeah, and your shoulders go up, and you breathe out of your nose, and it's a fucking goober laugh that everyone at some point has done, and it's just... You know,
dude,
but, I mean, that's an exaggerated
when Steve
version.
Steve does
it,
it's so exaggerated, and it's like that fucking goofy stoner kid who you grew up with. Who's just a sweetheart.
That's so fucking. It's so dumb. It's not even a good bit.
It's barely, but it makes me laugh when you do it, bro.
It's barely even a bit. It's barely a bit.
It's barely a bit.
It's not a good
bit.
It's not a good bit. I don't like the bit.
I don't think it's good unless you do.
You know, Yeah. Remember the other week when you guys were making fun of me for...
I think if it makes you guys happy, then I'm all for it.
I fucking love that about you, bro. I love that.
That's actually so sick. Thank you. It does make me happy. I love you, bro.
Thank you. Thank you.
I'm thanking you, too. You guys made fun of me for watching a chess show. You guys made fun of me, and you can say you didn't. You can say you didn't, but here's exactly what happened. 2 weeks ago, I think, on the pod...
I actually didn't.
Okay, well, then maybe it was just Kip. Well, two weeks ago on the pod... I said, you guys got to check out the show, The Queen's Gambit. And you're like, oh, what's that? And I said, it's a chess show. And immediately Kip just goes, oh.
Well, it's because, right, it's like when you said that, it's because you had just started playing chess again or something. And so obviously we're going to fucking roast you, man.
Yeah.
It got me back into playing chess. It wasn't
it's a good show. So they say.
Have you seen it?
No.
I've seen a little bit of it. It is a good show. It's really well
You
done.
Don't have to like chess at all.
I like chess.
What's the actor's name in it? Anya something? The main girl?
Asa Akira.
Right, that's the one.
Dude, both you boys just...
who's that, Steve? No, but she's cool. I like that actor.
Yeah, she's fucking amazing.
From The Witch. You've seen The Witch?
Yeah, of course. Kip? I love The Witch.
The main girl in it. The blonde girl.
Yeah.
And she was also in Split.
Yes.
Mm. Oh, dude.
Speaking of Asa Akira, she gets split.
Neville, the guy who played
Neville from Harry Potter.
Sorry, I just got the she gets
from Aragorn.
Neville from Harry Potter is in it too. Dude, he's been making a comeback. He's in The Devil All the Time.
Doesn't he look great too?
Wait a minute.
Oh my god,
is he the pastor?
Maybe it's not Neville.
No.
Maybe it's the person who plays Dudley. Neville.
Oh, sorry.
Yes, it is. Oh my God. So he lost a lot of weight, right?
That's what I was saying.
Yeah.
No.
That is him.
It's not Neville. It's
Oh my God, dude. I just watched Devil all the time.
Chordley, isn't it?
On Saturday night.
It's Dudley. Dudley from Harry Potter.
That's and his
it's Chordley.
Harry Mellon. Chordley's dude.
It's Casey Frey, dude.
Dude. It's
okay. So I knew I recognized that guy from somewhere. He's the first pastor in Devil all the time. I watched it on Saturday night. It's very depressing.
Oh, you actually watched it.
But I get it. I think that the story, like it, the plot kind of lost itself a little bit while still trying to be a little pretentious.
Yeah.
But like, I think I liked where it ended and I get it. And I think it was really cool actually, because you know how the whole time Tom Holland's character like totally like doesn't want to believe in God or like faith or anything, you know? And because of like all of his experiences, obviously it makes fucking sense. But then at the end, it was really interesting that the person that he like gets in the van with is a hippie that looks just like Jesus.
Mm. I didn't even notice that at all.
I think that was intentional.
That's actually so cool.
Yeah.
That's so cool. I just think that the performances in it are the things that really stick out. I wish I could remember what the meaning behind it all is. I think it's like, is it like fucking violence begets more violence or some bullshit?
If that is the message, then I don't think that message lands.
Maybe it isn't the message.
But I like the way it, like, halfway through, I was thinking, like, why the fuck is this character, like, from a plot, like, thematic kind of standpoint, why is this character, Tom Holland, able to do these things and get away with it? Like, where is the moral, like, placement? You know what I mean? Like, who's right in this? And then I was thinking, no, it makes sense that he's doing these things and getting away with it and surviving, because although like all the other characters are like maybe Christian, like the pastor and stuff like that, or like other people, he's the one who's actually in the right with what he's doing, who has like the right like morals behind what he's doing. You know what I mean? Even though the way he's doing it seems like he's killing people or whatever, but it's like, no, but he's actually in the right. So it made sense. Like there was probably, I would give it a 7 out of 10.
Yeah.
Like nothing insane. But yeah, the performances are great. And it was so cool to see Tom Holland do something like that. Like,
and once again, Robert Pattinson, every single thing that he's in.
Fantastic.
Unbelievable.
I hated that character.
I'd kiss that man on the mouth. You know what I mean?
Yeah. Big time, man.
Oh, for sure.
Big
You'd
time.
You'd have to.
You'd have to. Yeah. Oh, you got a little something in your left nose, man.
Oh.
Oh no.
Good thing you're editing this week. You can blur that out. You can pixelate that.
Just a blur like over his whole face.
I need to pull my nose now, dude.
Yeah, besides that, the only thing I've been watching is fucking Mandalorian. But yeah, Harry Melling. He's truly making a comeback. He was in Queen's Gambit, and he plays like a totally different character from who he played in He has quite a range. He really does. Oh God! It's so interesting to see him alongside Robert Pattinson, two actors that you never expected to really be at this point.
And they were both on Harry Potter.
They were.
Yeah, he was.
That's insane. I always forget that Robert. He was Cedric Diggory.
Yes, dude. That
Robert Pattinson was Cedric Diggory in Harry Potter. Kib.
Yeah.
Yeah, I know.
Yeah,
dude. That moment always like hits me. Because Cedric is just like
had that moment, yeah,
the guy, like when everybody fucking hates Harry and shit like that, Cedric, although he kind of goes along with it, dude, with his friends, but when time. It's like,
Harry? What, Harry? Oh, do it,
so
Harry?
Still, he's well, so Kip, we were still. Having a different moment. We were having a moment, not in the discovery that Robert Pattinson was Cedric, but that the fact that Robert Pattinson, and Harry Melling, AKA Dudley, are both in this movie together. That's so two amazing. Harry Potter stars from the past. Two child star Harry Potter people rejoining. That's an amazing thing that we only just realized now.
That's incredible, man. That's incredible.
Thank you, man. Finally, he gets it.
Can
you just be here with us?
Be
on our side for once?
Can you get serious, Kip? Can you get serious? Fucking pay attention, man. You're serious now. You're serious. Please. I'm sorry I snapped at you.
Don't snap at me.
This is so interesting to have conversations without having to talk over each other.
It's so much better.
Mm-hmm.
Oh.
Well, we are talking over each other, but at least like it's all coming through so we can fully just embrace it and be happy with it, you know, because that's who we are.
And
if anything, dude, if anything, what it does is now if I say something and I thought I had my a window where I could say something, but someone else already started talking and then the talking over happens. At least then I can hear that I'm talking over someone and so can the other person. And then they both can decide, do we continue to talk over each other or does one of us stop
talking? Yeah. Exactly. And I love
that. At least we can do that.
That's what it's about. It's about the choice. It's about the choice, having the choice to continue talking and continue cutting off your friends and just asserting that what you have to say is better and more important.
And we all
think that. Make the choice to probably just also continue talking over each other.
I need to figure out my game plan with this thing. I don't make a lot of plans in my life and goals or anything, but I need to figure out how long is this going to be here? What steps do I need to take to get off of this stuff? And where do I go from there? You know,
I don't think you're on it yet. Like, I don't think you're hooked again. I think right now, if you want to make a decision, then you should do it now.
Yes.
Then I think this is going to be the last thing I do.
Mm-hmm. Great. I think this. I've been doing this since the end of September.
Quit
so
same time.
Already a month and a half that I've been doing it, so I'm definitely more hooked. And no, I'll quit on my own.
All right.
No, I don't plan on quitting for the foreseeable future.
How long do these last?
2 days.
2 days?
If you're cheating.
Ugh. Then maybe...
Well, I've had this one since Friday.
Fuck. It's nothing like a jewel, I'll tell you that.
I remember jewels.
Because those pods last like a few hours. Or like a day, maybe? A pod lasts a day
like
for a jewel?
Yeah, when you're cheating, you know what I mean? Like, I think a normal... Somebody who's trying to quit smoking and is smoking just... to get their fix of nicotine.
And also
now
they're at work.
And stuff.
They're at work. And so they're not smoking all the time. They go out every hour for like a couple puffs and then they go back inside at work.
Even at home, I think
you know,
people who are genuinely
people.
Trying to quit and using the Juuls and the puffs as a transitional thing, don't smoke them all day, at least 5 minutes.
Well, that's the difference is that's how we started. We started smoking vapes. So we immediately were like,
we could do this whenever we want. I don't live in Canada. My parents can't stop me.
Dude,
I'm allergic to this.
I wish Rooster Teeth would have just been like, no, you can't vape in the office.
In the office.
No, that was like a stipulation. That was like,
it
we're
was
not
so
doing
dope.
It if we can't vape in there.
Oh, you know what? We also did break that rule at every possible time we could break
it.
If we went to a convention, RTX, dude, in the hotel rooms,
Steve.
Any fucking place we went to, we were fucking vaping. We told them we're gonna. They're like, you guys can't vape in here. And we're like, we're
dude,
gonna.
That was the one thing where we were like,
we didn't say it like
arrogant.
That. Don't make it seem
we
like
we did say that. I mean, it wasn't like that, but we basically said to the people we feel comfortable with, like maybe Fareed, like we're gonna, like we understand.
Yeah, but then to the higher ups, we'd say we won't.
Yes, yes,
we won't. But they just
they
didn't
knew,
understand addiction at the time.
They knew and we knew that it was gonna happen. But just that we would have to keep it under wraps, and we got snitched on a bunch of times too.
Oh yeah, fucking so many rats, dude.
So many snitches, dude. People would snitch like all the time at RT, man. I was always like, if you have a problem with it, just be like, just fucking talk to me, man.
dude.
And I won't. I won't stop. I'll continue doing what I want to do. But
I
at least
think
it
was those fucking handlers, man. What do they call them with Rooster Teeth? The fucking handlers, man. They manipulate fans into working for them. What do they call them?
Handlers? What are you talking about?
It's a funny word. They're not called handlers.
Well, describe their
the Wranglers.
The Guardians, I believe they call them.
Oh,
the
you
Guardians,
think the Guardians stole
the handlers?
Us?
Absolutely.
Man, are you about to throw some Guardians under the bus who volunteer for that work, man?
Dude.
You're
about to. Yeah, but that's like that thing, you know, the conflict of having an intern, an unpaid intern.
Dude, Kip just has a thing against the Guardians because they all dox him.
Well, don't dox me, man! Fuck! No, I mean, it could very well not have been, but like, I'm sure there was a couple Guardians that did not like us. And fucking...
We were always very nice!
Yeah, we were.
Yeah, they were always really
nice. And the Guardians were always very
nice.
Remember,
there were always like several that were there every year, and I remember, there was that one dude. Like, there were always like several of the Guardians that were like repeat Guardians every year and shit. And they were, I was really cool.
Yeah. I mean, they were always so nice.
But yo, yeah, I remember so at RTX Sydney, remember that was like the big like no-no.
Yeah.
Like, we were not allowed to smoke in the convention center. It was like Australia law. So it was different than like whatever state we were in. Like, it was a different fucking country. And we were there barely.
And I think
and
a lot of people
burn you on
yeah.
the crucible if you do.
And like a lot of people don't vape there. Like, we couldn't even buy vape juice anywhere. Like,
wow.
So we were just, but we were on fucking stage just fucking vaping and shit like that. And we got like several warnings and Rooster Teeth got, or at least no, the company
that got fired.
The company that like puts on RTX, it's not Rooster Teeth. It's like a third party company that like puts on events, right?
Come Expo.
Yeah, exactly. They got fined. Because of us vaping.
Yeah, like $100,000, which is why a lot of people don't realize that. That's kind of why SP7 ended.
Yeah.
No, it was all the fines.
Did they actually get fined?
They Probably. Actually got fined, but
I think they got fined like $100 every time we vaped.
That's
and we
so
vaped
funny,
at least 100,000 times.
But it was but we didn't know about the fines until later on.
Yeah, so they didn't tell us until like the day we were all leaving. Like,
I wonder if
yeah,
that
yeah,
was
like
the
they
straw.
Got fined every single time. And I was like,
if we knew how serious
that
was at the time,
there were
simply,
actual
dude.
Repercussions.
Because that's so disrespectful of us. But if,
yeah, that's
like,
so
I thought it was just like, a, you guys better stop vaping.
Yeah.
That's so disrespectful to us.
For them to tell us.
Can we
us?
Turn this around and we're the victims in this scenario?
Dude, I'm fucking pissed, man. That's so disrespectful, dude. I
wasn't
Kim
even wasn't
there,
even
man.
There, dude, and
I'm
he's
fucking,
pissed.
How dare they, dude? The audacity. To not tell them that there's going
to
be a
God,
fine.
I would love to go back to Australia.
I know, dude. I'm actually so stoked that you weren't allowed to come, Kib, because then I was able to go. And it was a
Wait,
blast,
you weren't
dude.
Able to go if I went?
Well, because they were only going to bring out two.
Really? Oh, I had no idea.
But that then Autumn came because Bruce or Autumn paid for them to go on their own.
Oh. I mean, either way, we would have fucking figured something out, dude. That would have been dumb if only two of us went. You know what I mean?
That's only two of happened. Us did go.
I know, but I mean, in a world where I could
did
have
you
went.
Do you think that you went to Australia?
Yeah, well, I went to Australia. What do you mean?
What do you mean? What do I mean? You didn't go
fucking,
to Australia.
Ask the fucking fans, bro.
Okay, what did James and I? Where did
and
we all
me.
Go during the day? What did we watch during the day while we were drinking mimosas? What was something out in the park that we were watching then?
There was a big chess thing.
Holy fuck, what? How do you remember that?
I was there, dude.
You were not there. Where were you then? You weren't with us.
Is he bidding, James? Or is he... He's
I don't even know if he's bidding.
Obviously he's bidding. What, dude?
No, you weren't there. You weren't there.
Yeah,
holy shit, man. Holy shit, dude. That freaked me the fuck
dude,
out, dude.
I literally was like, I'm going to see if I can push Steve to a point where he actually thinks I might have went. And
how
he's
do you remember the giant chess set?
I don't know. I have a memory of an image of there being a giant chess set.
I have a memory of an infant.
I have a memory of an infant playing chess in my head, and it just pops up every time.
Holy
it's improv,
shit.
Really.
Dude, I don't know what this equates to, like, my IQ level, what your chess score says about you.
Very
my
well.
Rank is 850, which is, like...
In the world?
The base level is, like, 1100 it starts you off at, which is what it thinks novice players are.
Oh.
And
so
I've dipped.
You're well below that. So
I'm well below it.
Like, you're like, you've lost 100 matches to go that far down.
I don't know how
row.
This has happened, man. I truly don't. I'm
lack
the worst
of
player
playing. You, we used to all play all the time. Physical chess. And like, even I was okay.
Physical challenge.
Even I was dece. You know?
Dude, yeah. There's a whole chess, like, streaming thing. Like, a lot of people stream
Blech.
Chess.
Blech.
And that's the end of that.
Moving on. Ugh, bro.
Oh my god, boys. I've been playing fucking Fallout 4 and it's so fun. I'm obsessed with it. You guys should play.
How many hours you put into that thing, dude?
Probably only like 8 so far.
I didn't really like Fallout 4 that much compared to like the glorious Fallout.
I've never
2.
Played any Fallouts. So
I told James this is great that
one.
He's starting with Fallout 4 because it's like
you can only get better now.
It's an updated version of Truly. Fallout 3, better graphics, better everything.
It's not as good as Fallout 3. It's not even comparable.
But if he went back and he started with Fallout 3, it's not going to hold up as well as if he started with Fallout 4.
But I didn't play it when I was younger when it came out. Canceled.
Yeah, Fallout 3 is the better game,
but
obviously.
Regardless, yeah, I don't even care because there are definitely like bugs in Fallout 4. And
James
like
hates bugs, dude. Cockroaches.
And I hate
rad roaches.
Bugs,
dude, James
dude,
gets so upset at any
good
glitch.
Reference.
Fucking
I don't
ruin my
don't
experience.
Have a don't have a fucking bug in a game that's fully released for years. Patch it. Figure it out.
Yeah.
Well,
but there are a lot of mods where you can patch them, like fan made mods that patch all the bugs that you can like just install really easily.
James, I have a question for you.
What's your question, Kib?
And are you're liking it a lot, Fallout 4? This isn't the question. This is a pre-question.
This isn't the question, but this is...
Is there any way that you can play Fallout 3 after this? Because Fallout 3 was...
I don't think I really want to. Just because, like, it is about graphics and stuff like that, and, like, I don't really feel like playing... Like, I don't like going back to, like, older graphics unless it's a game I've already played when I was a kid, so it's, like, nostalgia. And if I'm playing Fallout 4 right now, I'm gonna get my open-world post-apocalyptic fix with this game, so I'm not gonna want to play, like, another game just like it.
Yeah, the approach they take though on Fallout 3 is an experience I will never forget, and Fallout 4 doesn't. I mean, obviously, I guess you'd have to play Fallout 4 for the first time, having not played like exactly your experience to know if that was just as good. But like the experience playing Fallout 3, the approach they took was like
I gotta piss and shit.
Somebody get that sound, please. I fucking want that sound, man. The fucking sound
dude.
I gotta
you can do it. You're editing.
You guys are gonna hate that I'm bringing this up because you just don't give a shit probably. But I played with the developers of Among Us recently.
That's very cool. I think that's cool.
And they're gonna add a perm to the game.
For you?
Because of you?
Well, I think so. I mean, I don't think they know it's directly related to me, but it was asked. They're like, can you add a perm to the game? They're like, yeah.
That's so sick.
Isn't that sick?
Fuck yeah.
Did you go, hey, can you add a perm?
I was part of the please, can we get a perm in the game?
Wow. That's so fun. Amazing.
So just saying. Just saying. I am among us.
You are among them. Yeah.
Did I put 120 something hours into it now? It seriously helps with my short-term memory. No lie.
I'm sure it does.
Because you have to remember all these fucking routes. Right. And you have to and I've gotten so good at lying. Not actually. I'm not a great liar, but I've gotten better at it. Because of the short-term memory.
You're doing it now because you're like, oh, that sounded weird. I'm not a great liar, but I...
It did sound a little weird because I don't want to be thought of as a great liar.
And then you lied. You're like, now's the time to use it to make it seem like I'm not a great liar.
You're exactly right.
Thank you.
But it's not that I'm not a bad liar, but I mean, I started out as a bad liar. Right, but it's made me remember stuff so I can be a good liar.
Test
because
me right
I don't
now.
I don't know when that's...
Test me.
Someone
just died. Stop. Talk to me.
We actually have a sponsor.
Okay.
Sorry, bro.
Yeah.
Oh, wait. No, we only have one sponsor this week.
No.
What? I thought you said we had
what?
Three. I thought you said we had three sponsors.
Bro.
Didn't you say
there's three on there.
Mm. And that was a lie.
Oh! Wow.
That was really good.
Easy target, though. You know what I mean?
For our next sponsor, I'm going to go get all of my things from the next sponsor.
Fuck yeah. I'm wearing underwear. Yep. Undies from our sponsor right now. Just so you know. Mack Weldon. Dude, it's so... Their stuff is... They're fucking... At the very least, get their underwear. It's so fucking good.
I'll tell you
Mack
this.
Mack Weldon. What? Tell me what, man.
I got a bunch of their socks, and I fucking love them, dude.
They're
my
so good.
My favorite white socks.
And their masks are dope, too. Mack Weldon. That's our sponsor. They're a premium men's essentials brand that believes in smart designs and high-quality fabrics. Mack Weldon offers a one-stop shop for men's basics. Socks! Shirts, hoodies, underwear, polos, and active shorts. Whatever you need, Mack Weldon has you covered. Unlike the assortment of department store brands that make up your top drawer, all of Mack Weldon's basics have a consistent fit that you can count on. So true. Dude, I have so much of their... Oh, It's a one-stop shop for men's essentials, from socks, shirts, hoodies, underwear, polos, and active shorts. Mack Weldon promises comfort and a consistent fit. Oh, the versatility, boys. The versatility, boys. You're not just going to look great in Mack Weldon. Mm-hmm. Their underwear, socks, and shirts perform well, too. From working, dude, I hike in it. I hike in their undies. I shart in their undies. It's amazing. From working out, going out, going to work, or on a date, Mack Weldon is for everyday life. You go on a date, whoever your partner is fucking bites off your underwear. Oh, my God.
Eats it?
That's so hot.
Yeah.
The fabric technology is unreal. Mack Weldon offers a wide range of customized fabrics that can keep up with you no matter what your day looks like. You have an 18-hour day? Wow, bummer. Yeah. They have silver air knit, X dry knit, and warm knit technology. Oh, 18-hour technology, not an 18-hour workday. Weldon Blue. Mack Weldon has created a totally free loyalty program. Level 1 gets you free shipping for life. Once you reach level 2, by spending $200, Mack Weldon gives you 20% off every order for the next year. The guarantee that they offer is that Mack Weldon wants you to be comfortable. So if you don't like your first pair of underwear, you can keep them and they'll still refund you. No questions asked. Man, I have nothing but good things to say about Mack Weldon. Truly. So
they're amazing. And your, I got their masks too.
Yep. Mine are out in my car, unfortunately, so I can't show. Oh, wait. Here's one right here. Here's one of my little.
Oh, yeah.
I have the same one.
They have a cool camo design on it, too. I fucking love it.
That's very cool.
They're great, and they're
comfy. I fucking love it.
I got their white shirts. I got some amazing pants by them. They were the ones that in the picture had the I don't forget what they were called. They had the rolls on the bottom in the picture.
Mm.
And
The chinos.
They're so high quality. They're great. They fit great.
They're fantastic.
You know, love them.
So, to grab your all-black pack for just $98 while supplies last, you can visit mackweldon.com/pine.
Pine, baby.
Pine, baby.
So, and then you enter promo code PINE as well. And then you'll get 20% off your first order. So, once again, that's all black pack. You can get your all black pack for just $98 while supplies last by going to mackweldon.com/pine.
Pine, baby.
And then if you use code PINE, you get 20% off your first order.
Just to clarify, the code is PINE,
pine
not
baby.
Pine, baby.
Oh, yeah.
Right. Thank you, Mack
Thank
Weldon.
Thank you, Mack Weldon.
Thank you, Mack. Well,
so before I rudely interrupted you, what were you saying?
Oh God, nothing important.
I will be right back. I'm going to get some water. Don't say anything until I'm back.
I miss Nick.
He's coming back.
He's been gone
today.
He supposedly tonight. He did really great during his baseball games.
I heard. I also heard that he potentially hurt his arm very badly.
Really? I could see that.
Because at a practice, but the man, dude, he bought a, were you there when he bought the throwing cage thing?
Yeah.
And the radar to see how fast?
He gets on phases like nobody else.
Oh, it's so
random. He had that fucking sports phase for like a week, and now he has like a build out the outside den area.
Yeah.
And then replace the sports area. I wonder what he's going
to
do next.
I mean, it wasn't. Yeah, I guess he can't have the throwing thing up there, but it was never meant to be there permanently, that throwing thing. That was just like we were like talking about baseball, and then he's like, wish we had one of those things. He's like, I wonder how much they are. And we just started looking up all the fucking baseball things, and we got one. And I can throw a decent pitch, dude. It was a pitch that he said he threw when he was...
Nick's dad is very supportive of me.
Eighth grade.
Probably more so than his own son. Even though I'm not like pitching as well or kicking the ball as good, he still tracks it with the thing and he goes, oh, Steve,
throw?
You are so fucking talented.
What do you throw?
I throw about 22 miles per hour.
That's not bad, bro. Not bad.
Dude, all my muscles have atrophied.
They have, yeah.
Yeah, big time. I've lost 10 pounds in the past month.
Dude, I lost like 4.
I don't think 155 is a healthy weight
someone
that's 6'3".
You just got to put on some muscle. You're losing weight. You look good. You don't look too skinny or anything. But you need to maybe like do a little muscle stuff because you're burning all your fat away. You're going to waste away.
Oh, I'm on the teetering edge of what I should weigh. It says you can weigh, if you're 6'3", anywhere from 152 to 192
you're
pounds.
You're not 6'3", are you?
What the fuck?
You're the same height as me.
Aren't you 6'2"?
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm 6. I'm 1 inch taller than you.
We've
been over it. Man, I have to get this out of the way. I'm 6'3".
Okay. Yeah,
I'm 6 foot. I'm 6'3", man. It's because every time we measure heights, dude, I'm wearing sandals and you're wearing shoes and you're like, we're the same height.
We got the same dick.
Why do you always say that?
You used to say it too, man, and you just stopped saying it.
Do we have I vaguely remember it. Did I say that too?
You remember mine?
Do we have the same penis?
We have the same penis.
No, you guys use the same penis.
We use the same penis. That's what that's what we're thinking.
Neither of us have one. We use it's an external device.
A third party penis.
An external penis.
We just watch. We just cuck.
Well, it does RTX now.
Your penis stuff does?
Supports RTX, yeah. Ray tracing.
Guys,
Ray tracing
guys, I'm so excited for Thanksgiving because I'm going to Seattle and we're bringing Vinny, right? Because we're doing a road trip up there. Mm-hmm. And we're going to bring Vinny to the snow for the first time.
Oh, baby.
We got a cute little jacket for him and cute little little booties.
Dude, he's going to love that.
Dude, Vinny's such a sweetheart.
I love Vinny so much. No talk about Vinny.
Don't talk about him.
Shit, bitch. Sorry, man.
Yeah, bitch. Come on, bro. Bitch.
Fuck, man. That sucks, man. Shit, bitch. Man, fuck.
What are you talking about?
What the fuck, man? That sucks, man. Shit.
Whoa.
What the fuck? What do you mean, whoa?
Don't talk like that, dude.
I'm not talking like anything, man. Shit.
Well, we thought you're doing it right
there.
Shit,
I'm not telling you. Shut up, man. What the fuck?
It's a very poor, like, version of a kind of accent, I guess. I don't know what
accent. I'm not doing a shit, man.
Talking in a slang.
What the fuck are you talking about, man? Fuck.
Fuck, man.
That sucks, man.
Sucks, man.
Man, fuck, man. That sucks.
Shoot.
Oh, crap, man.
Crap.
Oh crap, man.
Boys, this podcast has some good energy. I'm really loving it. I don't know.
I've been having a good. It has been really good.
It's just like I thought I was gonna be really tired, but it's just like we're just sweet boys, you know. Just
I feel like when
boys.
We are a little tired, but it's like not when we're too tired. When we're too tired, then it's like we just want it to end.
Right.
But then when we're a little bit tired, where we're like relaxed,
yeah,
then
relax
it's just like a little carefree.
Right.
You know?
Yeah. Totally.
And I hope all you listeners out there are going to get back into vaping when you get the chance.
Nope, they're not.
No, I mean, no,
they're not.
Don't.
And
no,
neither
they're not.
Are we. We haven't vaped since March. Yeah,
this is going to be my last vape for the foreseeable future.
I think it should be. Bro,
it's
to be honest, I think that you have way more than enough self-control that it's actually surprising that you decided to even get your own now to me. I'm not disappointed. I'm surprised that you buckled, like just because you've got it. You know what I mean? Like
I didn't need to buckle. Yeah,
it does make you look at him a little less, right? Like,
right.
Think a little.
You have
less
to.
Of him.
It makes me look at me a little less.
No, I can't even believe it.
The reason I quit this thing is because it was instant gratification that I needed to find from another place, not just vaping. It made life too easy.
Where'd you find it?
Where'd I find it? Yeah. Through self-love.
Right. How'd you find that?
Yeah. Through exercise and I think we talked about it on a previous podcast where it's like I would just. Go on these hikes until the only thing I could think about was making it back to my car. And then I realized that I could get out of that mental phase.
Mm-hmm.
Like that you're not just stuck in it. So, and then by that time I was stopping vaping, toning it down and everything. So I was able to exercise more. So that was, and then I didn't need to vape anymore. And then, now I don't need to vape now. I don't know why I am.
Right.
I truly don't know what got me back
that. Are you feeling something that you're not getting?
That's a great question. I truly don't know. I feel like I'm fine. I think you know what it is. It's you start to get like any type of increase in viewership on anything gives you, or at least me in particular, imposter syndrome. So that's a stressor. So I think this is probably a counter to that, if that makes sense.
Interesting, yeah.
Well, then why am I doing it?
Probably because of the short stuff you've been working on, the films and stuff. So it's like you feel, you feel like you deserve it now.
Mm.
Maybe.
Possibly.
I really don't know. I haven't really psychoanalyzed it.
Well, I deserve it.
Get one.
Okay. You should.
Okay.
Do you want to?
Yep.
Do you feel the urge still at all?
Yeah.
I think totally. That's normal. I think whenever you're addicted to anything and then you stop doing that, you're always going to feel the urge somewhat. But then what changes is your self-control and you see the bright side of not doing it and that overpowers your want to do it. So you're still going to have the urge there, but then you just choose not to. I mean, I know I'm gonna stop doing it, but I also don't really care right now because I'm chilling. I think what can help me is because I've been kind of neglecting the exercise a little bit lately. Like I just haven't been running as much, and so if I pick that up and start running more, like I was, then I probably won't want to do it.
There's a thing about Nick. You guys know how he just chews all the like sunflower seeds in the world and spits them out. I mean, obviously it's the grossest thing that's ever existed. Obviously it's the grossest thing to have to find a whole sunflower seed full cup.
That's out there for
with
7
just
days.
Saliva and all that shit in it. It's disgusting.
It's not really that messy. Like
no, he keeps it contained.
It's just that there are that.
But
exists.
Then I felt bad for making fun of him for it because it's to counter his like oral fixation tendencies for vaping and all that. So it's like one of his methods to quit. So I felt bad for kind of berating him for that disgusting fucking habit of spitting out sunflower seeds in his thing. But no, he's just a good guy. He's just a good guy trying to quit. And I respect that. And I love
Is
my
he
boys.
To quit?
I think everyone that's vaping is trying to quit.
Right. Yeah, nobody who is vaping it, like is like, I'm just so happy with this, and there's like nothing even in my mind that is like, I shouldn't be doing this. Every single person who vapes or smokes or does any kind of drug or drinks a lot of alcohol always knows, maybe I should chill on this or cut down a little bit or stop doing it. Every single person.
And then
and
you
if you don't think that, you, push that you will. You will in a minute.
Suppress it.
Yeah. That's all you can do.
Yeah.
But, I mean, hopefully I'll be able to stop after this one. And
you will easily.
And
it's
I will,
not even
I
an
will
issue.
Stop.
I it's
will
not
stop.
Even an issue. You, I'm not even worried issue. About it. It is. It's a non-issue. And believe that. Don't use that as an excuse to be like, oh, I can quit whenever, because that's what it'll turn into. You know what I mean?
If I don't quit after this one, and James, don't let me hit yours anymore, please.
I won't.
If I don't quit after this one, you guys can beat my ass.
Okay.
I've never had my ass beat.
Dude, I already could. You know
dude,
what I mean?
Easily, easily. But so could I. And we've always wanted to. Kib and I, especially 2-on-1, dude, we've always wanted to.
Oh
we've
my God,
about it.
Dude.
1-on-1, I could. 2-on-1,
I've
always
James will beat my ass
to.
While Kib 69's me.
I accidentally, because he's going down on you, right? You're good on it, going down on him.
You're good going down on him, right?
And then I accidentally knock Kib out and he just falls. He just falls on your dick. Totally down your throat. What was that? What sound?
Playing it like a trumpet.
Oh.
Yeah. That's
blowing air into Steve's urethra.
Into his dick, and then it inflates his testicle.
Yo, dude. Next. Fuck. Yo, next week, can we read a fan fiction?
Sure. Fuck. I'm down. Sure. Are people still making those fucking twisted?
No, but they're out there. They're out there.
Yeah.
And I picture it like we should read a really vulgar one.
Oh fuck yeah, dude!
But only one. I don't know if I want to like imagine the things that are going on in that. And like, if I'm gonna be reading something as a character, I'm gonna be method acting.
Right, it's gonna influence James too much.
I'm gonna have to not talk to you guys or see you guys for like a while after.
There's gonna be a romance between James and Steve, and James is gonna fall in love with Steve.
Dude, that could be so funny to read a fan fiction.
I'm down to do it though.
Or it could really be trying. Or both.
Well, how about this? We'll try it. We'll try it, and then at any point we can stop.
Yo, I got a really startling notification on my phone the other day because
DMCA?
I logged into Nick's HelloFresh. It says, reminder, you have a few hours left. If you haven't done so already, please pay before 11:59 p.m. today or you will not receive your box. So it's looking like Nick is canceling. I don't know why, which
that's
means...
That's a bummer.
I bet you he just forgot. Absolutely.
The only reason I bring that up is because that is our final sponsor for the day, and that's it is something that's been a staple in my life for months now, months and months.
But don't they send you free... Don't they send it to you now for free?
Well, here's the thing. I sent an email to Daniel. I was like, hey, man, can you hook me up with the sponsor? Maybe they'll send me a free HelloFresh. And he said, yeah. And then he asked for all my information. So I sent him all that over. And then he made a group email that I noticed way too late that he was like, hey, let me get your guys' information. And James is the only one that sent it. And James got free HelloFresh. And I didn't.
Oh, but it was just a one-time thing, right?
Just one box.
That's still cool. That's still really cool.
It's still like, a
it was
month.
Amazing. Yeah. I had three fantastic meals.
That similarly happened with another people group.
Yeah, but we can't talk about that one, I guess. Yeah.
But well.
But well, your teeth are looking a lot better though.
Thank you, dude. They didn't send it.
Yeah. Okay. So, our final sponsor for the day is HelloFresh. You're probably wondering what is HelloFresh if you don't know.
What is
How could you not know, man? You can get fresh, pre-measured ingredients and mouth-watering seasonal recipes delivered right to your door. With HelloFresh, America's number one meal kit. HelloFresh lets you skip those trips to the grocery store and makes home cooking easy, fun, and affordable. It is fun. Dude, their recipes are actually fun.
Yep.
And James can attest to that, too. It's not just me blowing smoke out of my ass.
Dude, the box I got, one of the recipes is now one of my favorite recipes. Yep. It's the creamy, dreamy mushroom pasta.
Oh, baby. It's and you so just good. Only hit the tip of the iceberg, too. I'm so excited for you to try more.
Tip of the iceberg.
So... Here we go. HelloFresh has, let's just list it out, variety, sustainability, they're flexible, and they give back. That's three things. Just on the easiness, HelloFresh offers convenient, no-contact delivery to your doorstep for easy home cooking with the family. The recipes are easy to follow with simple steps and pictures to guide you along the way. I've made the same recipe a few times, actually, and you start to notice like certain patterns within the recipes, and you get used to them. And there are certain like gripes I have while doing it, and then they fix those. It's like they actually listen to customer feedback.
Wow.
That's fantastic.
Which is amazing. It's delicious and nutritious, and I can attest to both of those. HelloFresh delivers fresh, high-quality, pre-portioned ingredients, so you can make meals that are delicious and nutritious. And you don't—they don't send like an—they don't overdo the amount of whatever they send you, so you're not like wasting food or anything, which is nice. And you feel like you're getting more than enough when you eat. Like, it's perfect. Over 90% of ingredients are sourced directly from growers to ensure peak flavor and ripeness. I'm actually a grower, not a shower. So it's sustainable. They're the first global carbon neutral meal kit company.
That's amazing.
Yeah. I have a huge carbon footprint, so it's nice that HelloFresh is helping me.
Extraordinary large carbon footprint Steve has.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
By skipping the grocery store and using HelloFresh, you're reducing your food waste by at least 25%. HelloFresh delivers pre-portioned ingredients, so you're not overbuying, which is a burden on the planet and your wallet.
Don't forget your wallet, too.
Don't ever forget it.
So it's flexible for your lifestyle. Easily change your delivery days or meal plan preferences and skip a week whenever you need right on the app. The app is very easy to use. HelloFresh is committed to giving back. They donate to those in need. So far in 2020, they have donated 3.5 million meals. How about that?
Beautiful.
Only to me.
That's amazing.
Wow. And somehow you're still losing weight.
So you can go to HelloFresh.com/Pine90.
Pine90.
Unfortunately, there were 89 other podcasts that were beyond the pine.
Yeah.
And then you can use code Pine90 to get $90 off, including free shipping.
Oh, that's why.
So
it's
once
90.
Again, yeah, you can go to HelloFresh.com/Pine90 and use code
90.
But it's also important to use code Pine90 at checkout.
Yeah.
To get $90 off, including free shipping. Thank you, HelloFresh, for sponsoring the pod.
Thank you.
I love you.
Hello, Fresh.
Fresh. Oh, man, I want to get the new Call of Duty.
Cold War?
Yeah, will you guys play with me if I get it?
Dude, yeah, I'm playing right after this, literally. Addiction.
You're playing the new Call of Duty?
That's what I wanted to play with you, bro.
Damn, I wish I could, but I got to reserve my energy for later tonight. All right. I'm sorry, love.
I mean, you could just be, you don't even have to talk. You just play.
True. How did you already download the game and all that?
No. It's gonna be a
I'm
bit.
Playing right after this.
Bro.
I mean, I've got the fastest internet and from here
in
to
America.
The side of Mississippi, dude. You know what I mean? So I'm not worried. You
Yo, can
worried.
I actually show you guys something? I got new shoes I really wanted to show you.
Please don't show me your penis.
Don't show
I'm not gonna show you my penis. I'm gonna show you my new shoes, dude.
Don't show your fucking penis. Please show us your penis. Those are
Is
sick,
that,
dude.
Are those for Vinny?
Those
yeah.
are water shoes, huh?
Oh,
these are Vinny's
little snowshoes.
These little snowshoes, dude.
That's what a good boy.
Cute. Same
what kind
size
of jacket
as me.
Did you get him?
Oh, it's just a like black, like
Gucci
snow jacket, Gucci Louis Gucci.
He might
Gucci,
be the
Gucci,
sweetest
Louis
golden
Gucci.
Retriever that exists.
He's the sweetest dog that exists.
Well, actually, he's a lot nicer than Littlefoot to other
exactly.
dogs. I'll give you that. But he's built better.
You know, Odie's
You're right.
Odie could be. He's built better than Odie for sure in a lot of ways. But as far as sweetness,
Odie's pretty sweet.
Pretty sweet.
Pretty sweet. Not the sweetest.
But possibly.
But pretty sweet. But pretty awesome.
Pretty awesome.
But yeah, but he's pretty awesome.
He's a dog.
I am excited to quit vaping after this. I'm
yeah.
excited that we had an amazing podcast with our boys.
We had a great one.
Well, hey, let's make a pact right now. We're stopping right now.
The podcast?
That's the pact. I don't agree to the pact. Is the
okay.
thing? Is the issue?
I would consider this landmark territory.
This is landmark.
This is a landmark. This was 167, and it was a landmark.
V A R.
I feel like the last
you just said Lardvark, dude.
I feel like the last five podcasts have been 167.
Yeah, right.
Yeah, me as well. I agree.
I feel like because we just have thought that.
Do you think we'll make it to 200? I bet we will.
Oh God, yeah. Do you think we'll make it to 200, bro? Are you kidding? We're gonna get. This podcast is going to end at 327.
A nice round, even number.
All our
sponsors. How'd you get to that number,
us?
Man?
I'm just theorizing.
Because that's how many days are in the year, you think?
327, exactly. And
how many
dude,
days are in a year,
kid? This is going to happen, bro. They're going to fucking. How many days in a year? Ask me.
And I'll how many days are in a
you
year?
You shall receive.
How many days are in a year?
965? 900.
Oh, that good has gotten
Thank
me.
You.
How many is it? How many days are in a year, man?
Live 155.
Live 150. Did you say 555?
Six.
65.
365.
Yeah, man. That's actually fucking sick. I didn't even know.
Thanks, dude. I was just trying to teach you guys a lesson.
Thanks, dude.
Thanks, gosh.
We're just trying to teach you.
Who are we having on next week?
We are having on Nick. I eat diction.
Is it
Nick?
Is it? Eat my diction.
No, he's Nick. Not eat my diction anymore.
Oh, it's just diction?
Yeah.
Okay.
Like Nick dictionary? Diction.
I don't remember.
Is he really
said
good
that
with words? Is that why it's like dictionary?
No, it was a dick joke.
Mm.
Yep.
Classic.
And diction is, what does diction mean again? It's like a
it has
type
to do with
of,
speech or
you're like it's not your cadence.
Or something, right?
There's like oh, cadence, yes. Which is the way you speak, and then diction, which is maybe like
is that
your, is
vocabulary?
Your vocabulary?
I think. Sounds like it.
I'm gonna look up what diction means.
Maybe. Yeah.
Diction. The choice of use of words and phrases in speech. Okay, cool. So we were right. Dude, we're a lot smarter
right.
than we look.
I was right.
A lot smarter than I look.
Okay, man. You could have said we.
I did.
A lot smarter than I look.
Oh, man. I love you, boys.
I love,
you,
guys.
Man. Are you,
vaping for you?
Are you, streaming, Steve?
Yeah, I'm going to be streaming
all,
tonight
all
at 5
night?
Or 6, I think.
Till when?
I don't know. Hopefully not for probably 4 hours or so. I'll probably be streaming till 10.
I was going to say, let's go on a night run.
Night run!
But you're going to be streaming till late.
Uh-oh, yeah. He's doing the Vinny look. He's doing the Vinny look.
Oh, he's trying to be cute. Well,
it's not working.
I don't know. I really have to pee. I'll talk to you after this. Oh, fuck. I got to piss so bad.
All right, bye.
Oh.
See you guys next week.
Honey.
Thanks for watching.